Trikes are nothing new under the sun, but they have always been regarded, and rightfully so, as a vehicle with a niche purpose, delivery vehicles, meter maids rides, and as an alternative to two wheels for riders unable to hold up a bike. They don't handle particularly well, and behave poorly in the corners. Much of this changed with the advent of the funny backwards trike that places the third wheel up front. Suddenly, trikes corner as if they are on rails, and the genre has broken out of its traditional customer base. Back in 2006, Piaggio introduced the world to its MP3 scooter, further expanding the backwards trike concept out of the big bike sector and into the scooter realm. This was an important step, and the factory has been hard at work to incorporate more features and performance normally only seen on bigger, and more expensive, bikes into this little ride. Let's take a look at the 2016 MP3 500 ABS and see what Piaggio has going on over there. The MP3 profile looks much like any other scooter, albeit with an exceptionally beefy front end. This perception changes rapidly with your perspective as you move around to look at it head on. Now we see the major feature upon which all other design considerations revolve, the dual wheel front end with its articulated quadrilateral steering and suspension, which is what gives us the fat front end, cause the independent suspension members need room to work. This setup grants the MP3 an uncommon combination of attributes, stable enough to be self-supporting without using the center stand, yet capable of an astounding 40-degree lean angle in the corners. Much of the rest of this ride is fairly typical at a glance. The step-through frame, running boards, under-seat storage, and swing-mount motor are pretty standard fare for the scooter sector, and most of the really nifty stuff is hidden under the hood, as it were. One design feature I really like is the stadium-style pillion pad that places the passenger in a position to see over the rider's head, or at least around it. After all, what fun is it to ride on back and see nothing but the back of the rider's jacket? Though the factory made some adjustments to the frame to increase torsional rigidity, and tweaked the steering rake out 1/4 degree, the real showpiece of the chassis and suspension is the front end. A parallelogram type rack allows the front wheels, as well as the rest of the scooter, to bank into the turns a la two-wheeler style. This comes with a number of benefits, not the least of which being the doubled traction up front, independent wheel travel that increases traction on irregular surfaces, such as rain-slicked cobblestone streets, and twice as much brakeage up front where you need it the most since 70% of your stopping power comes from the front brakes. To put it bluntly, you would have to try real hard to pull a low-sider on this thing. Suspension travel is sufficient for a scooter, even one that weighs in just under 600 pounds wet, with 3.74 inches up front and 4.25 inches in the rear. The dual rear shocks come with a 4-notch preload adjustment to allow for changing cargo loads and / or the weight of a passenger. Dual, 240mm front brake discs and a single 280mm rear disc control vehicle speed under the management of the ABS system, a feature that boosts the already impressive traction and control afforded by the dual front wheels. Front and rear brakes are controlled primarily through hand levers on the bars, but the MP3 comes with a third option, a brake pedal that combines both front and rear under one control. This is important for our European brothers and sisters in the wind, because the combined brake not only opens up the MP3 to riders without a proper motorcycle license, in some areas, but it also serves to help new riders crossing over from cages whose first instinct is to stomp a pedal when things get dicey up ahead. A useful feature, but a crutch that prevents the rider from developing the proper hand-foot coordination necessary to ride machines with a more traditional setup. The beating heart of the MP3 500 is the 492.7 cubic centimeters, swing mount motor. This one lung, liquid-cooled mill produces 40.1 ponies and 33.5 pound-feet of grunt, not bad at all for a scooter, even one as heavy as this. A top speed of 89 mph puts highway driving safely within reach, but due to the engine size, mileage starts to creep down into full-size bike territory at 55 mpg. While this isn't a bad figure overall, you can forget about being the guy who rode around the world on 3 tablespoons of gas. Figuratively speaking, of course. Piaggio doubled down on the traction preservation angle with a feature normally only seen on bigger, more powerful machines, a dynamic traction control system Piaggio calls the Acceleration Slip Regulation, ASR, system. Wheel speed indicators monitor wheel rotation, and moderates power output via the ride-by-wire throttle control system to prevent loss of traction at the rear wheel when you get a little too twisty for the conditions. It's just a little lanyap for people looking to buy a ride with safety features taken to the nth degree. The final drive is typical, with a dry, centrifugal clutch and twist and go, continuously variable transmission, CVT, another feature that makes the MP3 500 particularly suited to inexperienced riders trying to break out of their cages for the first time. The MP3 goes for $8,999, and you can get it in black or white. This price does not include shipping and dealer setup, so bear that in mind as you dig into the accessories catalog where you will find plenty of opportunities to pad the sticker front where you need it the most since 70% of your stopping power comes from the front brakes. To put it bluntly, you would have to try real hard to pull a Lowe's either on this thing. Suspension travel is sufficient for a scooter, even one that weighs in just under 600 pounds wet, with 3.74 inches up front and 4.25 inches in the rear. The dual rear shocks come with a 4-notch preload adjustment to allow for changing cargo loads and slash or the weight of a passenger. Dual, 240mm front brake discs and a single 280mm rear disc control vehicle speed under the management of the ABS system, a feature that boosts the already impressive traction and control afforded by the dual front wheels. Front and rear brakes are controlled primarily through hand levers on the bars, but the MP3 comes with a third option, a brake pedal that combines both front and rear under one control. This is important for our European brothers. Trikes are nothing new under the sun, but they have always been regarded, and rightfully so, as a vehicle with a niche purpose, delivery vehicles, meter maids rides, and as an alternative to two wheels for riders unable to hold up a bike. They don't handle particularly well, and behave poorly in the corners. Much of this changed with the advent of the funny backwards trike that places the third wheel up front. Suddenly, trikes corner as if they are on rails, and the genre has broken out of its traditional customer base. Back in 2006, Piaggio introduced the world to its MP3 scooter, further expanding the backwards trike concept out of the big bike sector and into the scooter realm. This was an important step, and the factory has been hard at work to incorporate more running boards, under seat storage, and swing mount motor are pretty standard fare for the scooter sector, and most of the really nifty stuff is hidden under the hood, as it were. One design feature I really like is the stadium-style pillion pad that places the passenger in a position to see over the rider's head, or at least around it. After all, what fun is it to ride on back and see nothing but the back of the rider's jacket? Though the factory made some adjustments to the frame to increase torsional rigidity, and tweak the steering rake out 1/4 degree, the real showpiece of the chassis and suspension is the front end. A parallelogram type rack allows the front wheels, as well as the rest of the scooter, to bank into the turns a la two-wheeler style. This comes with a number of benefits, not the least of which being the doubled traction up front, independent wheel travel that increases traction on irregular surfaces, such as rain-slicked cobblestone streets, and twice as much brakeage up front sisters in the wind, because the combined brake not only opens up the MP3 to riders without a proper motorcycle license, in some areas, but it also serves to help new riders crossing over from cages whose first instinct is to stomp a pedal when things get dicey up ahead. A useful feature, but a crutch that prevents the rider from developing the proper hand-foot coordination necessary to ride machines with a more traditional setup. The beating heart of the MP3 500 is the 492.7 cubic centimeters, swing mount motor. This one lung, liquid cooled mill produces 40.1 ponies and 33.5 pound feet of grunt, not bad at all for a scooter, even one as heavy as this. A top speed of 89 mph puts highway driving safely within reach, but due to the engine size, mileage starts to creep down into full-size bike territory at 55 mpg. While features and performance normally only seen on bigger, and more expensive, bikes into this little ride. Let's take a look at the 2016 MP3 500 ABS and see what Piaggio has going on over there. The MP3 profile looks much like any other scooter, albeit with an exceptionally beefy front end. This perception changes rapidly with your perspective as you move around to look at it head on. Now we see the major feature upon which all other design considerations revolve, the dual wheel front end with its articulated quadrilateral steering and suspension, which is what gives us the fat front end, cause the independent suspension members need room to work. This setup grants the MP3 an uncommon combination of attributes, stable enough to be self-supporting without using the center stand, yet capable of an astounding 40-degree lean angle in the corners. Much of the rest of this ride is fairly typical at a glance. The step-through frame,